Let us see the other class available for the same purpose, that we have the calendar class. Now calendar class in itself is an abstract class, so we need some implemented class which we have as a Gregorian calendar. And to this you can have an empty or you can pass in any particular year, date or time. Let's say 1980, month is 10th and date is 20th. Now from this I'll just import. Now from this object I can get various information related to the date, which is 20th October 1980. I can print down all the information related to it. Day of the month, I can say c dot get calendar dot. I have various options. I can say day of the month, I can say what day of the week this is, I can say what month of the year this is, as you can see I got a whole lot of things that I can get from this object. As of now, I'm just interested to get the month. So I'll just dispose this and let us see what information we have. Now we get day of the week. So I have the day of the month is 20th as expected, day of the week is 5th. As we are not very sure what day of the week this is referring to, so what I can do is I can bring down a date object from this. I can say c.getTime and then I can as earlier simple date format SMP is equal to new simple date and just have the day format and say format this D. And print out the day. So this is Thursday. So we've got for any particular calendar object, through the getTime method we can get the date, and through the simple date format we can format it to get the exact day what we have. And then we have the day of the month is 20th, day of the week is this, and calendar.month is 10th. And the month counting, it goes from 0 to 11. So the December month is represented by 11 and November by 10. So this is according to it, 10 represents the month November. So in case I format this to get my year and month and date, as you can see it is giving me November. So I'll have to get this 9 in order to get October, because the month counting starts from 0. As you can see now, for 9 it is showing October. So similarly, we can use calendar objects to be compared. I can create another calendar object. Say 1981, and I can compare these two objects if c dot before cc. So we can say c is before cc, else we can say c is after cc. So this is how we can compare two calendar objects, and we can make sure what comes before. So we have c is before cc, which is clear from the date. This is 1980, this is 1981. So this is how we can get all information through the calendar object. We can get any day of the month, we can get day of the week, we can get any what month it was, what week of the month it was, and from that calendar object, in case we want to further show it in a different format, we can do it through a converting it to a date, and through the simple date format we can format the date into any format that we want. So this is how we can manipulate dates through the calendar class and also through the simple date format class.